Good morning, everyone. Happy ice cold Saturday in Wisconsin for you. It's been down in the 20s for Halloween. So we are in the workshop heating things up with another model kit build. This is AMT's 1960 Corvette 2-in-1 model kit. You can build it as a bone stock 60 vet, or you can build it as a mild street rod, or anything in between, which is sort of my idea. I'm not going to use all the street rod stuff, and I'm not going to do it as a plain Jane stock machine. I want to have a little enjoyment with mine. So let's take a little ride today and see what we're going to find in the box when you get yours. First up, we've got body panels, front and rear. This is molded in white styrene. We've got stock steel wheels, which would have the hubcaps over them. And then we have the wheel backs, which go with the stock or the custom wheels. We've got a nice little interior package here with our door trim on the side. Two-toning those doors will be a little bit of a masking effort, but it can be done. The seam in there is prominent and it looks nice the way it is. So we've got all that molded in there. We've got carpet molded. We've got our little shifter boot molded in there. And we've got our pedals. So that is nice looking, and we can get in there and do some work. We've even got the center logos and the carpet down the center for the transmission tunnel. On this tree here, we've got our dashboard, all full of gauges, radio cluster, climate control, all on there, just the way we want, and a steering wheel, which is one large piece. This is kind of resembles a promo style kit so far. We've got body panels. We've got a tonneau cover for the street rod or the stock version. You could always put that in. We've got, what is that, a hood? That's your hood. And then we've got a small hood scoop over here for the street rod version. We've got our V8 block and transmission halves. Air hose, firewall, which has a surprising amount of detail on it, stock manifolds, we've got our, what are those, little scoops on the side there, belt and pulley system with the generator molded in, radiator, fan. So we've got a lot of accessories on there, some stuff I haven't identified yet. We've got our axle blocks here, which allow you to have a stock height or lowered height on your ride. What else we got in here? We don't have a lot of parts in this kit. It's not going to be too hard to work on. We got the beautiful 60 body. Looks every bit of a 66 or a 60 to me. And we've got our taillight inserts. I like that those are open like that. We've got our emblems on here with marks to drill out the body for the emblems, to drill it out for the mirrors, to drill it out for the optional spotlights on the side, and the roll bars in the back. We've got all the holes pre-marked, no guesswork or anything. And the windshield frame is molded in on the body, which I thought, and a lot of the vets, they will have this as a separate chrome piece. So be careful when you snip out your braces on there. The front end looks nice. Looks like we'll be able to install our headlights quite easily. All of our trim pieces. We've got our windshield wipers molded in. Our vent. Got nice molding for the trunk. Doesn't look like we have to deepen in any graving. And I like that the trim is very, very prominent, because if you want to chrome that out and make it look nice all the way along the body like the box art, that's important to have that raised up. Now on the fenders here, I will have to mask that. I do have a very steady hand, but That's prominent, but it will be great with some tape on either side, and then we can chrome that. This one, I will probably do freehand, is strong enough on that big scallop like that. So that's a very sharp body, even has the visors included on it, and all the holes ready to drill. The chassis is very, very basic. We've got our differential molded in. We've got our front suspension molded in. We're going to be supported on steel axles. Our exhaust is all molded in. We'll be installing our engine in there, and then we will probably be doing some very small painting and dry brushing to accentuate that chassis. So that's it right there. That's all of the white styrene. Move over to the other side where I call the multimedia side of the desk. We've got two steel axles. Make sure you got two in the box. We've got our nice windshield. clear. You can see just a little bit of wavy because of the way it has to be molded around the corner. We've got a set of six pad printed tires. These are Goodyears. They actually have the sizes molded in as well as the Goodyear name pad printed. Nice tread design and black wall with Goodyear logo on the other side. They are hollow. They will fit over wheels. You get two of the wider tires, and we get four nice performance tires on the front. Goodyear logos, hollow, nice and flexible. Black wall on the other side. Beautiful pad printing on the front side, and an excellent tread pattern, and these tires always sand down lovely. So that's your stock and street tire options. We've got a set of decals here with some really cool black flames with white silhouettes around them. We've got doubled up on the dash gauges. We've got Corvette emblems, Goodyear logos, sponsor decals, license plates. We've got two complete sets of plates. And then we've got those flames and a big Chevy bow tie. Very small Corvette logos hiding right there in case you were looking for them. Nice decal sheet in this issue. We've got a big chrome tree. We've got the grille with the license plate frame molded in. We've got custom wheels. I like those molded open wheels all the way through. We've got seat belts here because there are a lot of chrome seat belts out there. We've got our side pipes if you want to use them. Corvette valve covers, tail lights, headlights are molded in chrome plastic. We've got our ignition and intake systems for the Corvette V8. And then we've got the nice stock hubcaps on either side. Here's those roll bars for you if you choose to use them. All kinds of options in this model kit. So I'm going to start gluing my 1960 Corvette together, and I'll be back in a moment. Thank you. Welcome back. Obviously, I'm doing some custom work on mine, having a good time with my Corvette, so we can paint it any color we want, we can do any interior, but as you saw in the thumbnail, I didn't go too extreme on that. What I did want to do is use some of the custom body pieces because I thought they would look good, and I really like the cover art of this kit. So on the chassis here, we've got the radiator installed. That just glues in positively to those little triangle shape squared off mounts there, so you know exactly where to put it, and the fan shroud rests right on the chassis. There's really no way you could get that wrong. Then we've got our axle placements all the way around the chassis, and at any time you could change from stock to lowered. It, you know, it's not like these are glued in there permanently or anything, so you can move those axles up and down wherever you choose. I removed the body pieces just to make sure that the fit with the bumper pieces and all of this, it actually fits onto the body correctly. I want to make sure that will go on there. What I'll have to do is use some poster tack or stickum to hold this on my painting table to get those sprayed in the body color. And then they actually get sandwiched with these in the center. So when you put your body together, which we'll look at right now, pop the hood out of there. When you put your body together, what you're going to end up doing is putting like your front bumper and grill trim in, and then putting the other half of the bodywork underneath it. There isn't any way to actually join the two together before we do this, so I can't glue them on like I always like to do. With the rear bumper, it's the exact same way. It has these nice large grooves. Those will fit right in there and glue in beautifully. And then the bottom part of the bodywork, right here, we'll glue in up underneath. There's no way to join those in advance or do any of that early, and it's hard to hold with just one hand or two hands messing with the camera like that. But we've got the body holes drilled out for the roll bars, for the emblems front and rear, for our mirrors on the fenders, and then I drilled out the passenger side for an aerial. It has two holes. You could put two antennas on it. I only want one. If it was my Corvette, I'd only have one radio antenna on, and I wouldn't have two for looks. So we'll put our mirrors on, though. Those will look nice. And then I attach the side pipe holders, which allows me to test fit and get everything in there. I might have glue in there now, but those will actually press in there nicely and sit right up against the body then. And that's how we hold those against the body without ruining our body with a bunch of glue later. So if you want to add those side pipes, you just install those little holders. I'll paint mine body color, and then we'll bring the side pipes out. They're gonna look really nice on there. So everything's coming together just fine. You saw me measure the hood to make sure I centered the hood scoop at least somewhat close. That looks awesome on there. I set mine back a little bit. You could set yours forward, back, whatever you chose to do. The rest of the stuff on here, like the belt and pulley with the generator, tonneau cover, battery, air hose, box there, and then our ignition system. I glued all that chrome stuff together because I want to paint that. I want it metallic, but I don't want it to be super bright chrome on my model. I just don't. The distributor cover will be metallic on mine. I'll leave it chrome. And we've got our beautiful chrome wheels. Those are those roll bars and all that stuff. So we've got good enough stuff to do. It was easy to assemble, as you saw. There was no fights, no fits, no nothing. I mean, it was very simple. I also cut the seat belts off. The chrome tree, I want to get those painted. When we paint them, we could either scrape off the paint where the chrome is, we could mask that, or we could just repaint it a more realistic color for those license seat belts. So I'm going to get all this stuff into paint. First I'm going to do is take this pretty little Corvette body and its hood, and I'm going to go over and as well as the dashboard, and I'm going to scrub those in Simple Green. You could also use dish soap. You can use any degreaser you want, just to make sure that when I paint the body, I don't have any fish eyes or any oily spots from assembly or from the factory injection process. I will see all of you in the paint session next. Lots of nice detail highlight this Corvette, but I think the interior pretty much takes the cake on this kit. Beautiful dashboard. Now, since mine's custom, I didn't silver in where it says Corvette. I just used a silver pen, same pen that I used to detail a lot of the stuff on the vehicle that you saw. Got our seat belts in there, red on red interior, and then we got that nice steering wheel painted red, black, and silver, and the dashboard. Now, on the dashboard, I used the speedometer, and I used the radio and climate control, but for the little mini gauges, I just used some of that gray wash that you saw me. And then because this is a mild custom, the radio speaker I did in a little silver tone. You can still see some of the red, like it's a little screen on there. And then I glued the shifter in and left all the shifter chrome, figuring it is a custom. The seat belts really bring it around, and I enjoy that. That is a sharp looking interior, and that dark red will look wonderful inside the body. We've got the tonneau cover done. Now you can use the tonneau, you don't have to, whatever you want. I did it and glossed it up like it is a vinyl, and we could put that on, we could leave it off. The bumper and exhaust I black washed, same with the grill, black washed in there, let it dry, and that looks fabulous inside there. You could also use black paint and stick it in there and have just about the same effect. You just have to clean it up more than that much thinner wash goes in and out. We've got the wheel and tire package on the car. The one that I chose, a little black wash in the center, that's it. Now, the rims are a little wide for these tires. You can see, you really should shave those down. I didn't know that before I glued them together. So that's your tip from Uncle Chris. Now, if you use the wide tires in the rear, don't cut your rear wheels down. If you use the all the way around, you'll have to take off, it looks like, about an eighth of an inch all the way around of those inner wheels. The wheels themselves. But the inner caps there on the wheels, and those Goodyears look tight on there. I did a stock height. The metal axle is difficult to get underneath the engine. You'll have to push the engine up a little bit and slide that axle in, or just simply cut the axle off and glue it into position in the front area. We've got that nice fuel injected V8. Our exhaust just sit in our little ports there, our transmission, and then I push the fan inside to make sure it was forward enough. Underneath, not much to go on down there, just exhaust and the black underneath. I left it absolutely alone on this kit. Sometimes I accentuate it, sometimes I don't. On this one, I left it alone. The body is ready to go. You saw how I did all the trim. We've got our taillights in place. We've got our headlights in place, and they look pretty good with a little bit of that Mod Podge on there. The windshield goes on beautifully. I've got the windshield washer tank and some minor details picked out on the firewall. When we're all done with the car, I will paint the visors, but I'm leaving them alone for now so when I'm handling it, I don't rub some stuff on my fingers. All the trim work is done. I'm not going to use the Corvette emblems that I drilled the holes for. They are too small and too prominent. Luckily, the decal sheet has exactly what we need to solve that problem. We've got our Corvette logos right there, and we've got our other Corvette logos for the fenders and everything else there. So we're not going to have to worry about those emblems being a little small. The side pipes, of course, will go on. I black washed them, left the tips chrome. All I have to do now is what I like to do on the tips of my exhaust, which is black it out with a Sharpie, and there we go. Looks much better, and then we were all set, so that's how I do that. We've got our air hose, which will go in once everything's mounted together, and then small details, the roll bars, I definitely wanted those on my custom, and since I drilled the holes, I will be installing the mirrors as well. We've got our body pieces here, and we are all set. So, I'll get all this stuff together, I'll apply my decals and a coat of Future Floor Polish, and I'll return. My buildups of the C1 Corvettes continue. I've built a few of them on the show, and I think all but all of them were from AMT. They all build up fine. There are some things you should know about this kit when you do your final assemblies. The hood fit can be quite fiddly, and sometimes it does not want to go in there without falling through or popping up high in one location. You may need to take a file of whatever type you choose and work on the edges of the hood, not so much the upper edges of the hood, but the hood sits flat And then the casting of it is kind of beveled on the bottom side so it doesn't go all the way through. You may need to work on that bottom side and sand it down and back and forth to get it to fit in just fine. Also, I do not like how high it's set with the stock height, with the axle position. And that's just a personal choice. So I did relocate both axles to the lowered position, and I think that is a very good look for this car. I think, you know, on the box art, it sits pretty high. But I like it dropped right down on the tires. Just enough room for clearance, but it looks good on there. That's my preferred method, which means when I move the axle up, under the hood, there was interference with the engine. So I had to cut the axle, the metal axle off, and glue it in as if it was a large pin on either side. That I ended up having to do. The headlights and taillights go in easily. The mirrors drop right in. The roll bars pop right in place. In fact, the roll bars, the antenna, and the mirrors are held in place with the floor polish. There is no glue needed. The lake pipes, the side pipes, are held in with just a couple drops of gel super glue. The grille and the rear bumper are held in with regular liquid super glue. I like the liquid super glue from the dollar store and the gel super glue from the dollar store. Whatever they have for sale at the time is what I grab, and it seems to work just fine. The limited number of decals I used on the dashboard, I used the Corvette emblems on the hood and on the trunk. Those worked beautifully instead of messing with those smaller chrome logos. And then the side Corvette flags look lovely and conformed right down. The trim is prominent. We were easy to chrome that. Everything else looks good to me. Remember to sand the inside of those wheels if you're going to use the little bit narrower wheels. The license plates went on without problem, and nothing had to be custom fitted to get the bumper and the roll pans on the front or the rear to fit in and look nice. Nothing had to be messed with or ground down or sanded or anything. They were just pushed up into place and glued in place with super glue, and they look wonderful. So I enjoyed the kit. I like my styling details on it. I did the tonneau cover. It's removable, so I can take it off for some of the pictures, but I wanted to put it in for this one. I did the visors in a red to match the interior, since it is a custom ride, and used that hood scoop, which being open on the front, it's not open through the hood, you could always cut it, but gives you that deep texture on there. I enjoyed the kit. It was an easy build. It's not very difficult. When you're fitting the final body on the chassis, you literally just have to spread the body and it'll fall right down over and hold the chassis in place while you secure your bumper and your pan. I don't think that you can secure the bumper and the pan before you put it on the chassis, but I did not try, but it doesn't seem like it would fit very well if you didn't do those at the end. But like I said, no worries. They glue in place. They go right in place without a problem at all. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this over and for having a lot of fun with me. We've talked on the phone. You guys are going to see some cool stuff coming out. They give me a call. We're talking about some plans for kits and brainstorming and stuff like that. And I know you guys like all the cool stuff that they come out with. So keep your eye open for that. Thanks to you for taking some time out of your weekend to watch the show. I always appreciate it. Stay warm. It's getting cold out there in many parts of the country. It is building season, and I'm going to keep building. So I will see all of you at the next review.